Without taking much of the time, the topic which has been assigned to me is diabetes and oral health. So I will begin my talk with the following flow, with introduction, then we will move to prevalence of oral disorder. What is it? Then how does diabetes mellitus adversely affect the oral health? Then oral health, how it affects the sugar control. Then periodontal treatment, how it positively affects the diabetes. What are the mechanism and impacts? What else we can do? And then the conclusion. So oral health and disease of hard and soft tissues of the oral cavity, they are usually neglected because we think that is a dentist milieu. And we, as a diabetologist, never look at it. But the link is very complex between both of these. They are a two-way street, actually, because diabetics are two times more likely to get the gum disease. And by the end of my lecture, you will be tempted to see the oral health of all of your patients. So what is the prevalence of the common oral diseases? Let us try to see. The majority of any population in the world suffer from the periodontal diseases, the gum diseases, which has two mainly forms, which are reversible, which we know as gingivitis, which affects 50 to 90% of the adult population once in their lifetime. Chronic form is periodontitis, which affects 10 to 15% of the subject. Now, it is sixth most prevalent condition in the world, which is considerable. It is variable between regions and countries, but it is the sixth most prevalent condition in the world as far as conditions are there. And the children which are there with type 1 diabetes, they have more gingivitis, specifically gingival bleeding and calculus, than their peers who don't have diabetes. So the global burden of disease 2010 survey, two decades data was there from 1990 to 2010. And the prevalence of edentate, those without any teeth people, they show that the people without teeth has actually decreased. There is around 50% decrease in the patients who have lost their teeth. So it should be a good sign, because this was patchy again, different parts of the world showing different improvement in the loss of teeth. But the improvement was there, but it is not a golden word, actually, because more the number of natural teeth which are present, with increase in longevity, we need to take more care of our teeth. There are more teeth which are present there to contact infection, and it becomes challenging with our glycemic control. So this is also seen that when the teeth are lost, it is associated with depression and poor self-rated, poor esteem in young patients and all those things. Then the second condition is caries. The caries is most prevalent condition, which was there according to the Global Burden of Disease 2010 studies. Now, how, with this vast prevalence of oral manifestation, how does diabetes adversely affect the oral health? Let us see. So this is a very recent review what Verles and colleagues, it described the illustrated potential oral complication of diabetes. And it showed that periodontal disease, which are there, they are affected by hyperglycemia, because hyperglycemia affects all the soft and hard tissue of periodontium. So gingivitis, it is more common in diabetics. There is more prevalence of periodontitis. The loss of teeth is again more common in diabetics. Now, this dysglycemia, which is very adverse. Hello? Can you mute yourself, please? Dysglycemia, which is there, it adversely affects the periodontal health in a dose response manner. That is, when higher is the A1C, there is greater prevalence and progression of periodontitis. You can very clearly see in this graph, as the age increases, the periodontitis prevalence increases, but with the increase in A1C, it again increases. Now, even the lower level of hyperglycemia, which we in Indian settings sometimes miss, the A1C, which is there from 5.7 to 6.4, which we call as pre-diabetes, this has a detrimental effect on periodontium. It even affects the periodontium. So we should be much cautious, because as you can clearly see, the uncontrolled diabetes, even at the level of 5.7 to 7, it affects the periodontium. And it is again a dose response pattern, but it is more common in men as compared to women, maybe due to the eating habits of men. Now, it is more important systemic disease, diabetes, than any other disease which adversely affects the oral tissues, because there is a sufficiently strong GRIF which is there, because this is that risk predictor which has in recent time by periodontitis case definition is created by a collaboration of European Federation of Periodontists and American Academy of Periodontology. So they have included a special class for those patients with diabetes. Now, people with diabetes have 50 to 90% greater risk of implantitis. Once we implant a tooth, then there is a higher risk of infection. Especially in children with type 1 diabetes, it is seen that those with good metabolic control, they have a lower caries risk as compared to their counterparts, which are having a bad metabolic control. Then regarding the periapical lesions, there is a study which shows that there is double the prevalence of teeth with periapical lesions in uncontrolled diabetics as compared to controlled diabetics. Now, this is really interesting. While surfing literature, I came across it, that there is an early tooth eruption in children aged 10 to 14 years. Those who are with diabetes, they have an accelerated tooth eruption as compared to the normoglycemic children. There is again a higher chances or higher incidence of dry mouth because people with diabetes suffer from hyposalivation. It can be due to diabetic neuropathy, changes in the salivary gland, which are generated by prolonged hyperglycemia, or maybe due to polyuria because the patient is in volume depletion. So these all leads to a decreased salivary flow, which were slower even in children aged 10 to 15 years with type 1 diabetes. So it was a common phenomena. With decreased saliva level, there is a function of saliva, which is cleansing, lubricating, digestive, and antimicrobial. So all these are affected. Now, tooth loss is more in diabetics. There is a lot of literature on that. And there is usually a double the risk of tooth loss in diabetics as compared to the normal population. Candidiasis, we all know, is more common in patients with diabetes. Delayed wound healing is very common in diabetics. Now, this is something interesting, which is iron precipitation in dental tissue. It is called as tooth bone. There is an iron element in the dentin so that the tooth is covered by the enamel on the crown. But not on the root. So by this, we can even catch the patients that they are having a dysglycemia. Especially the oral cancer risk is more common in patients with type 2 diabetes. There is an overall 15% higher risk of developing oral cancer. Now, it also affects the oral microbiome. So because the microbiome, we all know, is present there in the oral cavity. And there is a study in Mauritius which found that oral dysbacteriosis happens. The bacteria becomes disturbed in patients with type 2 diabetes, and there is a higher prevalence of Streptococcus mutans, which is a cariogenic bacterium. So caries are more. Now, how oral health adversely affect diabetes? We have seen that diabetes affects the oral health. Now it is repaying it. So oral health, how it adversely affects the diabetes mellitus. Now periodontitis adversely impacts the glycemic control. This is shown by various studies because the patient, those who have periodontitis, they have poorer glycemic control. In poorer periodontal health, have more diabetes related complication also. Not only the diabetes is more, the glycemic controls are poor, but the complications are more. And fasting blood sugar levels are higher in patients with periodontitis. Now, these are the potential pathway for mechanism underlying what is the effect of periodontitis on diabetic neuropathy. You can very clearly see age, alcohol, genes, hyperlipidemia, obesity, smoking, stress, and vitamin D deficiency. These are all the soil on which this is laid. And this leads to immune dysfunction or hyperinflammation. Then added sugar causes chronic overexpression of pro-inflammatory mediators, leads to beta cell damage in pancreas, which causes hyperglycemia. And this hyperglycemia in turn causes a lot of things. It causes mitochondrial leukocyte to become activated, free radicals are generated, then we have neuropathy and all those things. So in a way, oral health is affecting our pancreas, our liver, and in a way, it is affecting the overall metabolic health. Now caries, if we have caries or our patient is having caries, the sensitivity to hot and cold we know is altered, or the sweet or sour tasting is altered, and we can have pain during mastication. So this all leads to poor nutrition and poor glycemic control. The same is with tooth loss. When there is loss of tooth, there is trouble in eating and hence decreases the intake of healthy diet, which are mainly fruits and vegetables and coarse grains and all those things. So intake of soft foods, often laden with fat, sugar, salt is more, and that also impairs the glucose metabolism. Now, oral diseases other than periodontitis, they also affect the blood glucose values. Now, the reverse, when we treat these periodontal disease, how it positively affects the diabetes mellitus. Let us see. So periodontal therapy in type 2 diabetes, when we do, it leads to significant decrease in inflammatory markers, TNF-alpha and CRP. So another review was there which showed a decrease in IL-6 level when the patient was controlling for obesity. And non-surgical periodontal treatment also reduces HbA1c, not only the surgical one. The extraction of the teeth which was diseased, what was the effect on glycemic control? When I thought to see there was a full mouth extraction of teeth which was done, and which with terminally advanced periodontitis, and it leads to decrease in systemic inflammatory biomarkers along with local biomarkers and decrease in A1C in type 2 diabetes. Now the cost which is associated with periodontal treatment and healthcare. There is a direct dental treatment cost, which is around $298 billion annually. This is such a huge number. Then periodontal treatment is estimated to decrease the annual healthcare cost. So it becomes more significant to reduce the healthcare cost so that we can have our periodontal tissue in shape. Now the mechanism which are there are both chronic inflammation based diseases, because periodontitis and hyperglycemia are a chronic disease and they affect each other. They go in tandem, and these two occur usually in the same individual. Now there is a conceptual model how this disease occurs. As I told you, the periodontal infection lead to inflammatory response, increased level of interleukin 1, 6, TNF alpha. Then there are acute phase response, which is generated by liver. It causes increase in level of CRP, and the sites which are affected are all over the body, because it leads to affection of pancreas even. And then it can cause increase in blood glucose values by a direct mechanism. Now, quality of life, because this becomes really important in the present scenario. So there was a study in Amsterdam with 700 odd patients, and they show signs of poor oral health and poor quality of life together. Then in Michigan, they again did a study, and then they found that the patient, those who had oral diseases, had poor quality of life. And missing teeth or having loose teeth, because if they are there, they hurt during mastication, they leads to lower self-esteem, depression, and sometimes leads to a decrease in socialization even. So the need is of interprofessional collaboration. Oral healthcare should be given, awareness should be created between children, adolescent, and adults with pre-diabetes or type 2 diabetes, or the caregivers should screen in their dental clinic each and every patient for blood sugar values. And it is very easy to take a finger stick and then take a blood sample. And it is up to us. We physician could play a more active role in addressing the oral health of adult. So the first step around it should be make everyone aware about the potential role of the oral health in the management of diabetes. Now there are certain guidelines for the same. This is a guideline which is given by IDF for oral health for people with diabetes, which is being done in collaboration with World Dental Federation. It's just a 12-page booklet, and our own RSSDI guidelines for oral health for people with diabetes, because it has been given as a management for periodontal disease in patients with diabetes. A good clinical practice guideline, which was a joint statement by Indian Society of Periodontology and Research Society for Study of Diabetes in India. So the take home from this today's stint was, because both these diseases have a vicious cycle and they both negatively impact each other. Dysglycemia impacts periodontitis and periodontitis impact dysglycemia. So the thing is to treat the periodontal diseases, because then we can reduce the blood glucose values of our patient and reduce the inflammatory markers. Missing teeth can be a bad sign for patient, because it can lead to improper diet and subsequently lead to poor nutrition, and it can decrease the quality of life as well. Prosthetic replacement of missing teeth should be done. Patient should be counseled for the same and motivated for the same, because that can add up to their quality of life. And screening for dysglycemia in dental practice should become a must. With that, I thank you all for the patient listening. Thank you.